Welcome to Electronline, and another very interesting application, something that almost most of us are familiar with, where we have magnetic fields and moving charges, has to do with microwave ovens. How do microwave ovens work? Well, they need to produce microwaves. Microwaves is an electromagnetic radiation. And how do we produce electromagnetic radiation? Well, typically we do that by making electrons accelerate. One way to do that is through an antenna. Let's say we have an antenna and we polarize the antenna. We make one side positive, the other side negative, so that positive charges move in one direction, negative charges move in the other direction, and then we switch polarity. When we switch polarity, we make electrons move up and down, and the electrons moving up and down accelerate back and forth will produce electromagnetic radiation. We do radio broadcasting that way, for example. But microwave ovens don't work that way. They work with what we call magnetrons, a very strong magnet, and allowing electrons to rotate or move in circular paths. Now, we already knew that, because when electrons move in circular paths, that's caused by the magnetic field, for example. So let's say we have a electron moving in this direction, right there, so velocity is in this direction. Since electron, negative charge, use your left hand, put your left hand and the fingers in the direction of the motion electron, then turn your hand to turn your fingers in the direction of magnetic field coming out of the board, and the force will be downward. And so as the electron is moving around the path, you can see that the force will always be perpendicular to the motion of the electron, causing the electron to move in circular path. So a magnetron works that way by causing electrons to move in circular paths, and thus with the and circular paths means constant acceleration. It therefore produces electromagnetic radiation, and we want it to be in a particular wavelength, 2.45 gigahertz, which is the frequency that is easily absorbed by water, and therefore food that contains water can then easily be heated up. All right, now let's see how that really works. Well, it turns out the only variable factor in here is the strength of the magnetic field. Let's figure out how that works. So first of all, we know that the force felt by a charged particle magnetic field is going to be equal to Q times V times B. Of course, we know the charge of an electron. V is the velocity, and B is the strength of the B field. You say, well, how do we know the velocity of the electrons? Well, we'll get to that in just a moment. Also know that we're going to have a centripetal force, which is, of course, caused by the magnetic field, which is equal to mv squared over r. When we set those two equal to each other, we have the force of the magnetic field equal to the centripetal force, or qvb is equal to mv squared over r. If we solve that equation for v, notice we have this cancels out that, so we have QBR is equal to MV, or V is equal to QBR divided by M. All right, now, when particles are moving in circular paths, we can also calculate the angular velocity. The angular velocity is equal to question mark. Well, we know that the tangential velocity is equal to R times the angular velocity, or angular velocity is equal to the tangential velocity divided by r. And of course, tangential velocity is this velocity right here. So v divided by r is actually the angular frequency. So when we put these two equations together, we could then say that v over r, by moving the r down here, is equal to qb over m. And of course, v over r is equal to the angular frequency. So we have omega is equal to qb over m. Now, what is the relationship between angular frequency and the frequency required in the microwave? Well, we know that omega is equal to 2 pi f. So we can then say omega can be written as 2 pi f. So we have 2 pi f is equal to q times b divided by m. And since we know what the frequency is that we need right here, we can then take our equation, say the frequency required is equal to q times b divided by 2 pi m. We know the frequency has to be 2.45 gigahertz, or if we solve that equation for the magnetic field, which is the factor that we don't know, magnetic field is equal to 2 pi times the frequency times m divided by, let's see here, we have f, 2 pi f times m, and we want b divided by q. And this is how we determine the magnetic field strength in a microwave oven, irregardless of the size of the oven, irregardless of the size of the radius of, and this should be a Q. I don't know if this is visible or not. So Q, there we go. That's a better way to write Q. And so now let's plug in some numbers to see what the strength of magnetic field would be in a microwave to produce 2.45 gigahertz waves. All right, so the strength of the B field required is equal to 2 pi times 2.45 times 10 to the 9th hertz. Multiply that times the mass of electrons, 9.11 times 10 to the minus 31 kilograms. And divide the whole thing by Q, which is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19 coulombs. And that should give us the strength of magnetic field required in the magnet in a microwave oven. So 2 times pi times 2.45 e to the 9th times 9.11 e to the 31 minus and divide by 1.6 e to the 19 minus equals, and I have a strength of 0.088 teslas is the strength of magnetic field needed to cause electrons to accelerate at the right circular acceleration, or angular acceleration as I should say, to produce microwaves of the exact wavelength we need to cook food. And that's how we use magnetrons in microwave ovens.